Aphrodite, the goddess of romance, love, lust, and passion. Aphrodite is probably the most unique origin story of any of the deities on this list, although there are two of them. If you remember way back to when the Titans were fighting the primordial gods for the first time, Cronus cut off Uranus's genitals and they fell into the ocean. This giant splash created sea foam from which Aphrodite was born. In other stories, she is simply one of Zeus's children. Aphrodite is said to have incredibly intoxicating divine power. Only Hestia, Artemis, and Athena were immune to her charms. Aphrodite is understandably known for having relationships and did so with all the Olympians? Let me double check that. Okay, so I guess that's only technically includes Hephaestus, Ares, Poseidon, Hermes, and Dionysus, which are only the males who aren't Zeus. And that's just of the Olympian gods, not including anyone else. Overall in her myths, she's presented as an extremely protective and caring mother, but an unfaithful and spontaneous spouse. This, along with the two birth stories, led to a later creation of Aphrodite Urania, or divine love, and Aphrodite Pandemos, or common lustful love. There's also speculation that this was an idea influenced by puritanical Christianity, who didn't like the gross physical sexy times to be the same as pure divine love, so take that with a grain of salt. Notably, there was also another, unrelated form, Aphrodite Araya, who was found pretty much only in Sparta, and was closer to an Ishtar, Astarte, or Freya, a goddess of love and war. What's holding Aphrodite back in this list is that she's a little bit of an unbalanced energy. Her domain is love and passion, after all, and there's not much that can be more unbalanced than that. Once again, this is the A tier, so it's not a huge thing, just honestly something to be aware of.
If you enjoyed this video and want to see more about all paths, religions, traditions, and pantheons, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. If you really, really liked the video, please be sure to hit that like button and leave a comment telling me if I should cover the Norse or Egyptian pantheon next. Either way, thanks for watching, friends. I'll see you around.